Which engine oil should I use? This is right up there with other questions that have started revolutions, overthrown governments, and started world wars. Are two strokes better than four strokes? Which is the best tyre? But today, let's just look at the most common questions when it comes to engine oil. So many riders get obsessed with oil. If I use the wrong brand, will this happen? Or if I don't use a synthetic oil? Or go 10 kilometres over the oil change interval? Hopefully you will feel more relaxed by the end of this video. A few quick notes, if you're happy to just follow the manufacturer's recommendations, this video will be irrelevant. But if you like following the advice of fellow idiots, go for it. And I'm well aware of the irony here. My video is probably just contributing to our general ignorance. Thirdly, do your own research. The problem? It's almost impossible to find objective scientific research about motorbike engine oil. Much of the information comes from the actual oil manufacturers, and of course most magazines, social media influencers and riders are just happy to keep repeating what the oil manufacturer said. These guys love to blind us with big words and get us into the oils with higher profit margins. Check out the research links in the video description that I used for this video. I'll be keen to hear your own conclusions. Okay, can I mix different engine oils? This is usually when you are topping up your oil but using a different brand. All the experts and tribologists agree that this should not cause any problems if both oils are within the recommendations of the manufacturer. Can I change from synthetic to mineral or vice versa? Again, the tribologists see no problems with this as long as both are suitable for motorcycle use and within manufacturer's recommendations. Do I have to use the manufacturer's recommended brand? Now it gets interesting. Why use a different brand? Well, the recommended brand might not be available in your country, or maybe you are a tight ass, you don't want to pay a fortune for their synthetic wonder oil. Here's an example.
Baby seal engine oil. When only the best will do.
And some guys are skeptical of the manufacturer's recommendation and think they can do better. Well, could you? We do know there are big profits here. A motorbike manufacturer might get free oil to put in their bikes in exchange for recommending brand X. Or a really big manufacturer might get financial kickbacks as well. The really smart motorbike manufacturers just come up with their own brand of oil and recommend that. But look, generally, I don't really see a reason to not trust the motorbike manufacturer. They do want to make sure their engines keep working in the long term. Personally, I suggest just stick with their recommended oil during warranty period at least to avoid problems. Do I have to use the manufacturer's recommended oil change intervals? Generally, again, I can't really see a reason not to trust the manufacturer. It's in their interests to make sure their bikes will last. However, some riders are skeptical. Why? Well, some believe that oil change intervals might be lengthened on certain motorbikes where owners would like to do minimal oil changes, maybe road bikes and adventure bikes. The motorbike manufacturer might sell more bikes if it's seen as incredibly low maintenance. Is this true? I don't know. You'd really need to be testing them independently with an oil analysis to know for sure. In other cases, riders may think the manufacturer's intervals are too often, especially if they are not racing their bikes or riding them aggressively. A good example, Honda's CRF 450L with a recommended oil change at only 1,000 kilometres or 600 miles, which does seem a bit crazy for a supposed dual sport bike. Other cases, guys are riding, say, enduro bikes in a very relaxed way and want to double their oil change intervals. Now, some have gone to the effort of getting an oil analysis done and getting confirmation that this is okay. Again, I don't have any fixed opinions on this. Do your own research. Should I use synthetic oil? Now, this is really interesting. Synthetic oil costs a lot more, but it does have some advantages. It can withstand higher temperatures, doesn't break down as fast, better lubricant qualities, and leaves less deposits behind. Okay, I will play devil's advocate here. High temperatures, even motocross bikes stay well within the temperature range of mineral oil. Stick with the recommended oil changes, you should have zero problems. Mineral oil breaks down faster. Yes, this is true, but again, stick with the recommended changes, you should have no issues. Also, many forget that oils contain a lot of additives, and these break down no matter how expensive your synthetic oil component is. On top of that, your oil gets contaminated just the same. Unburnt fuel, partially burnt hydrocarbons, atmospheric dirt, metal wear particles, blow-by carbon particles. Many argue that changing your oil when recommended is probably more important than whether it's synthetic or mineral. What do the manufacturers say? Well, for motocross bikes, Honda recommends mineral oil. They don't even bother mentioning synthetic oil recommendations. Oddly enough, for their RX cross-country range, they say either mineral or synthetic. Suzuki just recommends mineral oil for their motocross bikes, although oddly they recommend a synthetic oil for their USA bikes. Yamaha's Enduro and motocross range, they have both a mineral and synthetic recommendation. Take your pick. Kawasaki recommends two types of synthetic oil for their motocross bikes. Overall, I can't help feeling the Japanese would not recommend mineral oil if it didn't protect their engines in the long term. I don't have any firm conclusions here. Are you happy to spend up big on synthetic? Go for it. Are you happy to use a quality mineral oil and save some money? Go for it. If you are racing or always pushing your engine hard, maybe err toward the synthetic oils. Ditto if you are an adventure rider pushing your oil change intervals. But otherwise, I would suggest just stop stressing about it. I've checked with a pile of very experienced mechanics and they all concur. If you aren't pushing your engine really hard, a quality motorbike specific mineral oil will be fine. Do I need a special oil for braking in new engines? Not nowadays, just pause to read this opinion, which is pretty typical of what the tribologists all say. See our video on braking in new engines for more detail. Can I use car engine oil? The main reason you might hit issues here is that car oil contains friction modifiers, which might cause your clutch to slip. Just look for the JASO MA on the back. Every motorbike engine oil will have this. Car oils don't. And if you are interested, Google 540 Rat. He's a mechanical engineer who did exhaustive testing of oils and considered even the best motorbike oils to be quite inferior to the good car oils. Interesting reading. He has caused a lot of controversy. Are cheap oils okay for two strokes? This is a common question because essentially you are only lubricating the transmission of a two stroke, whereas a four stroke oil also needs to lubricate that critical bottom end and top end. So arguably a two stroke oil isn't quite so critical. Look, in the end, it's the same story. Just follow the manufacturer's recommendations or do your own research and choose either a quality mineral oil or synthetic. So there you have it, some rough answers to the most common questions. So what do you guys use? Your opinions on synthetic versus mineral? Let us know in the comments, keen to hear.
Song Grasshopper! You think you need to change dirty engine oil? Wrong, dung beetle. Instead, focus on dirt within and let engine oil change you. Become Samurai Enduro Hero instead.